Okay, welcome to issue 95 of the Delorean build. We're working on the front of the car today. The first job we've got to do is do some work on the front bumper. The first step is to put in the little indicator lights, or side lights, marker lights, whatever you want to call them, these little fellows here. And they're held in place by the little tiny AP screws. So let's do the first one of those. Okay. Using the size 0 posi drive. Either these screws are getting smaller or I'm getting older. I think it's the latter. These orange lenses, they do look pretty realistic. They're actually quite good. I'm using a size 0 there. I'm just going to swap over to size 00 because I think that might fit a little bit better. Let's just try it. No, in actual fact, as with many screws in this kit, the posi drive number 1 actually fits them better. Wound up. Okay, that's the first one fitted. And we do exactly the same on the other side, again using the AP screws. In real life, of course, the difference between these amber lights is that on the European models, they're purely used as directional indicators. And on the American models, they're used as sort of side lights or marker lights, whatever you want to call them. And on the European models, they're only there as directional indicators. As the US and European lighting regulations are a bit different. Hence, on the real cars, the wiring looms are slightly different. Give those a final tighten. Again, I'm going to use the posi drive number 1 because that seems to grip the screws a bit better. Okay, that's step 2 done. Got both of the front lights in. Now, next stage is fitting these little fellows. These of course hold the flux bands in place. And how many have we got to fit of these? 1, 2, 3, 4. Got to fit 5 of those. And we'll be using the LP screws. It can only go in one way up. There's a little, you can see it, there's a little pin at the bottom, so you can only fit them one way around. And did I say LP? Yeah, they're the LP screws. which are slightly bigger than the AP. Complicated build this week, but it is a bit fiddly. One of those jobs where I wish I had really tiny fingers. They really are fiddly to get in these things. That's gripped it. Make sure that's lined up with the pin. Okay, that's the first one in place. And again, the positive drive number one seems to be fitting the screws a lot better. Done a bit quicker. Under it now. Okay. And it doesn't really matter which order you put them in. Number three. Sure that's lined up, yeah. And I wonder if the ones on the end are a bit awkward. Let's try one of them. Again, the positive drive number one size fits it better. that a wiggle, check that's secure. One, two, three, four. There's two more to go in. Knit that up, and just one more to do now. It's the final one on the end of the bumper. Okay, there we go. That's all six of the flux clips in place. Okay, let's just turn the page, and I think it's just a case of popping it on the front of the car now, and making sure that the LEDs, let's just check which way up it goes first. That way up. And I just want to make sure that the LEDs go into the little holes properly. Okay, it's one in. Slightly so I can press it into the hole tightly. There we go. Before I put the final screws in, there's four DM screws to actually hold it to the car. I'm just going to power it up and just check that those LEDs are working. Just put the power on underneath. And hopefully, there we go. Yep, there we are. Everything's lighting up nicely. There we go. Good. Turn the power up again. Right. Okay, and the final step is to use four of the DM screws to hold the bumper into place. One. 2. Screw for this issue. And there we go, that's it. That's the front bumper and the front indicators fitted. That's this issue complete. We'll just have a look what's coming next week. It's not immediately obvious what that is. I think it's the door sills. I'll just read what it says. With your next issue, you will receive a balance for the left side of the car and a step. These will be added to your DeLorean by following the illustrated guide. And there we are. That's what's coming next week. And that's issue 95 done. Hopefully, I'll use the switch from that side. You have to go in the passenger side to get to the switches, then. There we go. There's the headlights and side lights working. That's great. Okay. That's issue 95 done. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.